It's time to make a decision. Jesus Christ is calling you today. Today, Jesus is calling you. You may not be here tomorrow. Jesus died on a cross for you. Jesus died that you might have forgiveness of sin, that you might be reconciled to the Creator that made you, the true and living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God that created all things. But there seems to be a misconception with many of you today who claim to serve Jesus. You claim to be Christians. You claim to have these beliefs, but yet you still use these services at Target, Starbucks, these ungodly people. You give them your money. This is not what Jesus would have you to do. They want to put men in the women's bathrooms. The CEO of Starbucks is on record saying that he does not want Christians' business. So, Christians should use some discernment and come out from among them. It's time to stand up for something. The day will not be long till Jesus Christ will come. It said like lightning in the east, every eye will see him break the clouds. And on that day, it'll be too late to get it right then. There'll be no time then, but right now, if you're breathing, right now you have a chance. Right now you have an opportunity to take heed to the call. Jesus is there for you today. Right now, he's there. Tomorrow, he may not be there. Well, excuse me, he'll be there, but you may not be here. That's the problem. You may not live for another day. The sad thing is that Jesus died for our sins, but so many of you got this message mixed up. You think that you're saved to go back into your sin. That's the problem. That's the problem. That's why there's still even a business called Target, a business called Starbucks, because you so-called Christians keep using these products. You keep giving wicked people your money. When the Bible says, stand not in the counsel of the ungodly, sit not in the seat of the scorners. The CEO of Starbucks says he doesn't want Christians' business because he's in favor of abomination marriages and every other evil thing that they can press on you, but you keep giving them your money. You should, today is the day to decide who you serve. Who do you stand for? If you're a Christian, you should stand up for Christian things. It's unchristian for Target to force men into women's bathrooms. If you're a Christian, you need to make a decision. Do you understand that one day, God is going to divide every single one of us? The sheep will go on the right, and the goats will go on the left. Many of you that say you're Christians, many of you say you serve God, you say you love God, oh, you love Jesus, but it's time to show that love. How do you show that love? The Bible says, this is how I know that I love God because I keep his commandments. Jesus Christ did not die so you could have excuse to go on living in your sin. Jesus Christ did not wash you clean from sin that you could roll back around in it like a dog eats its own vomit. That's what this generation is like. That's why Christians, so-called, can go to these companies and give their money to Starbucks that wants to force you cake bakers to bake homosexual marriages, cakes for homosexual marriages. This company Target that wants to force men into your women's bathrooms just because someone's messed up in their mind and doesn't know which way, what they are, whether they're a man or a woman. This person needs a mental help. They don't need to be catered to in such a manner, forcing this agenda onto us. If you're a Christian, you should stand up against this. It's time for Christians to do their part. It's time to be found doing the will of God. It's not the will of God to go on in ungodliness. The Bible says, sit not in the seat with the scornful. Take no counsel of the wicked, but with the righteous. If you're righteous, that's the only ones that are going to go to heaven. You can fool yourself from now till eternity, but I'm here to tell you that one day when you stand before God, all your excuses will be over then. All of your excuses will end right then. Every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Jesus Christ will come against all of your abominable ways, America. All the things that you keep on funding, all the things that you keep on condoning, all the things that you keep on supporting, wicked, abominable things, but you say that you're a Christian, you think you were born a Christian, most of you, you don't recognize that you got to make a decision with God and God alone. It can't come from your grandmother. It can't come from your grandfather. It can't come from your sister, your brother, or anybody else. You gotta choose Jesus all by yourself. And if you choose Jesus and you still go on in evil things, you need to wonder about your decision. You need to wonder, did that really take? Because God said that he's able to clean you from the utmost to the uttermost. But I see that Christians want to just keep making excuses while they keep on shopping at these stores that are wicked. Target, that says they want to put men in the women's bathroom in Target, and you still spend your money there. It's time to think this thing through. Starbucks, you really want a coffee that bad? He says he doesn't want Christians' business. The CEO of Starbucks is on record saying he does not want Christians' business. Why are you Christians still using his business? Why are you giving him your money? He's the same person that funded those cake bakers to get put out of business because they wanted to stand up for the truth. It's an abomination for man to lie with another man like a woman. God is not taking an opinion poll. God has already spoken. He's already spoken, and I'm here to tell you that you better repent or perish. That's the truth. You're either going to be going to heaven or you're going to go to hell. There's a standard. God has not made it hard to understand. He said that if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. When Jesus comes the second time, he will no longer be a lamb. He already did that. In the second part, he's coming back as a lion, and he's going to set things straight. 8. He's going to put most of this wicked generation right now in a fiery hell. Even you that say you're Christian. Why? Because you go on in your sin and you talk about grace. But the Bible says, should we continue in sin, that grace would abound? God forbid. If you're living a life that God forbids, how is it you think you're saved? You're fooling yourself. Them that are given over to the strong delusion, them that are deceived, they're deceived with all deceivableness. Why? Because you have not a love for the truth. The truth is this. What God said in the beginning is the same thing He's saying in the end. He doesn't change, not yesterday, today, or forever. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. You need Him. You need Him to be washed up clean, to be reconciled to the Father. He's the only way to heaven. The way, the truth, and the life. There's no way to get to heaven except by Him. I'm here to tell you, Grandma can't get you there. Your Uncle Dudley, the deacon, can't get you there. I'm here to tell you that pew that you bought at the church will not get you into heaven. Only Jesus Christ. And He said, if you love Me, you'll keep My commandments. Grace was never given for you to go on to have a license to keep on in your wicked ways. Why in the world are Christians still going to these businesses that support this abominable thing, this abomination that is a generation right now? I'm here to ask you a question. Oh, Christian, why do you still drink Starbucks coffee when they're funding gay weddings and they're funding these lawyers to take people and put them out of business for not bowing to this LGBT abomination? Why in the world? Oh, you laugh now and you will mourn later. I'm here to tell you, if it doesn't make you weep, then you are not saved, because it's a shame the way you're treating My Jesus. I'm ashamed of you, America. I'm ashamed of the way you treat my Jesus. My Jesus died on a cross that you could be set free from sin, and you mistake it and think that means you can keep on in your own sin. You think that God loves you so much that He just doesn't even mind the fact that you're treading on His name under your foot. You're stomping on the blood of Jesus every time you go on watching your pornography, every time you go on with your wicked people that you hang out with and mock other Christians, real Christians, the ones that are willing to die for their faith. Those are real Christians. They're not the ones shopping at Target laughing about it, saying, oh, that's just too much. No, real Christians will suffer. That's the truth. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says it's better to suffer as a Christian than to suffer as a murderer. Oh, Target shoppers, you better watch your bathroom. There might be a man in there. They want to put men in the women's bathroom. They want to be in support of all these things that God has said from the beginning is an abomination. I'm here to tell you that the God of this universe is not taking an opinion poll. He's not asking for your thoughts about what He said. He said it's an abomination for man to lie down with another man. Like this, even animals know better than to do this. But these two companies, Target and Starbucks, they both support this thing, and you continue to support them. There's something wrong with that picture. I'm here to tell you, if y'all were as many Christians as I can walk down the street and y'all say you're Christians, these parking lots ought to be empty. They say they don't want Christians' business. Why in the world do you keep giving them your money? They stand up for abomination. It's an abomination, the thing that this former administration nation had been forcing on this country, the gay weddings, every other evil thing, men and women's bathrooms, every other evil thing. Why in the world are we still supporting these companies? There's something wrong with you. You say you love Jesus. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. Jesus said, why do you say you love me and you don't do the things that I do? Jesus wasn't drunk with the drunkards. No, but he reached out to them. Yes, he reached out to them. Just like he would reach out to a homosexual and say, hey, there's a way out from your sin. You don't have to be that way anymore. You could be set free. But he would never, not ever, and he does never support carrying on in your sin. You need to get some understanding, Christians. Everybody here says they're a Christian, but you keep on going on in your sin. You're going to find out you're wrong one day. You're going to find out that you're going to be in the same hell that everybody else is going to. None but the righteous will be saved. None but the righteous will see God. Neither fornicator. That's right, O America. All you young people that don't want to get married, want to shack up with somebody, try it out for a little while, see about that, see how it works out. I'm here to tell you, if you die in that sin, you're going to go to hell. I don't care about how many times you got dunked in water. You can get baptized in every pond in this county. If you die in fornication, you will die and go to hell. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says neither fornicator nor adulterer, idolater. Oh yes, sports fans, all of you idols, all you idol worshipers, you're going to go in that lake of fire, that place that you think it's only murderers and thieves. I'm a good person. Yes, I don't murder anybody. I pay my bills on time. Blah, 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 blah. You know that your righteousness is filthy rags before God. I don't care how good you think you are. You need Jesus. Jesus Christ is the only way that you'll be spared. And Him, the only way to be spared by Him is to live by Him. If you're living by Him, you're not living in sin. If you live by Him, you're not supporting these wicked companies forcing solid Christians to make homosexual wedding cakes, like Starbucks does, forcing women to have to suffer men in their bathroom like Target does. Christians wouldn't do these things. People following Christ don't support wickedness like this. The Bible says, sit not in the seat of the scornful, nor take counsel from the ungodly. Why in the world would you give ungodly people your money? It's awful hard to earn. You want to give it to somebody, to the devil? It's time to get some understanding. The Bible says in all you're getting, get understanding. This is understanding. This is the conclusion of the matter. Fear God, keep His commandments. For this is the whole duty of mankind. God made you to serve Him, but He gave you a choice whether you wanted to or you don't want to. If you don't want to, that's all and good, but know that you are choosing a choice that's eternal. And if you choose to not serve God, then you're choosing also to go in that place, that lake of fire, that place that was appointed for the devil and all of his demons. It wasn't made for you. That place that's been expanded. Why? Because most of you are arrogant, rebellious, and you frustrated the grace of God. You went down in some water back when you were 11 years old, and you came up the same sinful mess that you went down at. Now you're only wet. That was the only difference. You got wet, so what? It's time to repent. John the Baptist said, I baptize you with water, but I'm here to tell you of one mightier than me. And when he baptizes you, he'll baptize you with fire. If you've been baptized by fire, you aren't going to be too quick to go back into it. Yes, Paul was a murderer. Yes, he was. But after, when he repented, he gave his life. He gave his own life for the gospel's sake. That's what it means to be a Christian. Not going on in the world the way you've always went. Not just doing what everybody else is doing. Keep on going to Starbucks. Keep on supporting all these evil companies. And keep on doing these things. And when you get in front of God, don't be surprised when you hear, depart from me, you worker of iniquity. I never knew you. It's time to repent, America. The abominations that are being forced on us right now are a direct result of your lousy lives. You go to church on Sunday and you think that gives you license to live sinful the rest of the week? You think that you can serve God and serve mankind at the same time? No. You either serve God or you serve the devil. One or the other. It's time to make a decision. Choose Jesus. He's the only one that's got the words of life. I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ would set you free. But you don't want to be free. That's the problem. Most of you like your sin. That's the problem. You think you're okay. You think because you didn't kill anybody, you paid your bill on time, you think that you're a good person. Well, you just might be in somebody else's eyes, but I'm here to tell you that in the eyes of men, you see that there's a way that seems right to a man, but the end is death. And that's not just death leaving this place. That's death going to a real hell. A hell that was made for the devil. So keep on supporting Starbucks and Target and all of these abominable companies that tell you boldly that they don't want Christians' business. Why in the world do you keep giving it to them? It's time to get some discernment. Get some understanding. Do you see that the things you do is what you'll be judged by? This is how you ought to judge your own self. The Bible says, examine your own self to see if you be in the faith or not. You know you're not in the faith when you're living in fornication. I don't care what your grandma said. If you die in fornication, you're going to go to hell. Be not deceived. None but the righteous shall see God. It's time to get some discernment. Neither idolaters. We say now, well, we don't make wooden idols to worship. No, you don't do that. You have sports teams you can worship. You have singers on TV that you can worship. You have all kinds of ways to worship. You worship all types of things, and you don't even recognize that's what you're doing. That's because they're so deceived by the devil has gotten your eyes shut. But I'm here to tell you, you need to open your eyes today. I'm praying that somebody is going to hear this word. Somebody is going to open their eyes and have eyes to see this wicked nation that you're living in is on its way to a real hell. A hell that was not created for you. It was created for the devil, but it had to be expanded. The Bible says it's expanded every day because of wicked men. Arrogant, rebellious, each one. You think you're okay. You think because your bills are paid and you got a little extra money that you're rich. But I'm here to tell you, the Bible says, woe unto you to have riches. Woe unto you because you're comfortable now. You see, one day you're going to realize that you didn't know anything about your spirit. You didn't know anything about the time to come. You're comfortable in your life now, but you're not looking ahead. You're not recognizing that your soul is an eternal soul. Every soul on this street is an eternal soul. You're going to live forever. You'd think that was good news, but I'm here to tell you it's bad news for most of you. It's bad news to realize you're going to live forever in hell. That's no good. You don't want to live forever in hell. Each one of you is going to live forever. You have a soul that's eternal, but you're caught up thinking about all of these things that are temporary. You're caught up thinking about, well, it can't take all that. That's what I hear all the time. It can't take all that. Well, it does take all that. Jesus said, why do you say you love me and keep not my commandments? It takes all of that. He said that unless your righteousness exceeds the scribes and the Pharisees, you will in no wise enter into the kingdom. Those Pharisees and the scribes, they put on a real good game. They did a lot of good stuff. They did it all for the wrong reasons. And that's what you've got to overcome, oh Christian. If you're a Christian, come out from among them. This world is evil. It's time to come out from this place. All the things of this world, they're not for you. They're against you. This company, Starbucks, they support gay marriage. Not only do they support it, but they support the forcing of it on everybody else. It'd be one thing, you see, if two guys wanted to walk around saying they're married. That'd be one thing. But the bottom line is, they're not satisfied with that. They want you to bake the cake. No, they're not satisfied with walking around saying they're married. They want you to make the flower arrangements for them. They want you to take their picture while they're doing it. Yeah. And that's what these companies support. They say they don't want Christians' business. They'd rather have just homosexuals' business. Well, I think they would go out of business if that was really their business model. If you Christians would get some discernment, you would put them out of business. And that would be justice. It's time to repent. The time is short. Jesus Christ is going to come in the sky, and he's coming for those that are blameless and without reproach. He's not coming for you whoremongers that put fish stickers on the back of your car and go on living in fornication. He's not coming for you gamblers. He's not coming for you drunkards, you thieves that would steal his glory. He's coming for people that love him. People that will suffer for him. That's who he's coming for. First Peter said it's better to suffer as a Christian than a murderer or a thief. Whether you realize it or not, spiritually, if you're not spreading the message that you've been given, you are just that. It's a hateful thing to know that your name neighbor is going to go to hell and you don't tell them about it. That's hate. There's no greater hate than you can imagine. You think they won't like you. They won't like me if I tell them about Jesus. They won't like me if I tell them that sin they're caught up in is going to take them to hell. Well, I'm here to tell you, they might like you now, but they won't like you very well at all when they end up in hell, and you could have told them. Oh, yes, oh, Christian. You've heard John 3:16. I don't need to be out here telling you about it. I'm here to tell you something different. If you could only be saved by one verse, God would have gave you a fortune cookie. But He didn't give you a fortune cookie. He gave you a Bible. He gave the Bible by 40 prophets that all died to give you a Bible, and you don't even open it up and read it. Take the time to understand what God is telling you. You think that John 3:16 is all it takes? But Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. How would you know what those commandments are if you don't open your Bible? How can you know? This is why you go on in the seat with the scornful, strengthening the hand of the wicked companies like Target that want to put men in your women's bathrooms, wicked companies like Starbucks that want to force people to take part in gay marriages, abomination before God. These things are abominable, and God is not changing His mind. God is not taking an opinion poll. The Bible says, though hand joined in hand, the wicked will not go unpunished. You, in this world right now that perpetuate this wicked agenda, you will face God and you will find yourself in hell. It doesn't have to be that way. You can turn from your sin. You can turn from your sin. But I'd like to know, the last time I was here, I was told that everybody that works in Starbucks is a Christian. Well, I would say if I was a Christian and I was working there, I think I'd find myself a new job. I think that I would get on my knee and say, God, I know that you would not have me strengthening these wicked people's hands. I think that if I was working there and I realized that, it wouldn't take too long to find somewhere else to work. And if I needed a coffee, I would go down to the gas station or downtown. Maybe there's a coffee shop down there. Somebody that maybe is a real Christian. But there's no way in the world that I would keep on funding these wicked people. The Bible says it's a wicked thing to strengthen the hand of the unrighteous. Starbucks, they want to force you to take part in their abomination marriages. Target, they want you to allow men into the women's bathrooms. When you give them your business, you're strengthening the hand of the unrighteous. It's ungodly. Jesus said, why do you say you love me and do not the things that I do? Jesus wouldn't give these places any of his money. You shouldn't either. It's time to repent, America. It's time to get some understanding. The blood of Jesus is not something you just trample on and go on in your sin the same as ever. No. On the last day, as you all stand before the great white throne for your judgment, Jesus Christ is going to put the sheep on the right hand. Yes, those that are obedient, those that love God and are willing to suffer for Him, that are willing to go through it for Him, that recognize it's not about me, it's not about you, but it's about Jesus. When you recognize that, you'll suffer for Him. You'll change, you'll allow Him to change your life. He's going to put those people on the right hand, and they're going to end up in heaven, and they're going to go to that place where there's no sorrow, no pain, no crying, no dying. But the left hand is going to be the goats. That's most of you that say you're Christians. Goats. Most of you right now are on a broad road leading to destruction. You say you're a Christian because you got dunked down in some water, because you paid some tithes at a church house. But I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. All these other things are good things to do, but if you're doing them for the wrong reason, He's not in your life. And this is how you can tell: when you continue in sin, when you continue to sin on and on and on, you're like a dog that returns to its vomit. You say you're saved by the blood of Jesus, but you return back to that what He just washed you from. You're taking His word lightly. You don't care about His word. That's the problem. That's a goat. Goats are going to go to the same hell. You know the sad thing? The wicked people that want nothing to do with God, they're going to go to the same hell as you goats are. You that went to church, wasted all your Sunday mornings, getting up early, wasted all those dollars you put in the plate. Why? Because your heart has never been right with God. You're just like Judas Iscariot that walked around all those 3.5 years doing all the miracles, witnessing all the deliverance that took place, and never really receiving the message in his heart. That's what you goats are like. You say, when you're in trouble, God, get me out of this trouble. If you get me out of this trouble, I'll change. And then when the trouble is over, you go right back to the same thing you've always done. And then when someone challenges you about it, you say, I know I'm saved. God has got me out of all this trouble. Well, I'm here to tell you, just because He didn't strike you dead when your hand was in the cookie jar, He was not saying it's okay to steal cookies. What He was doing was giving you a space to repent. Right now, if you hear the voice of God, harden not your heart as in the day of provocation, that you will no longer be able to know the truth because you'll believe it's a lie. That's the way some of you are right now. Some of you have been lied to, and you like those lies so well that it won't be till Jesus says, depart from me, you worker of iniquity. It won't be till that horrible day that you finally believe just how lost you've really been, because you're a goat. Goats go to hell. Sheep take their stripes just like Jesus did. Sheep flee from fornication. Sheep flee from ungodly people like Target, Starbucks. Sheep wouldn't be caught dead in these places unless they are there to rebuke them. That's what somebody does when they follow Jesus. They don't go on giving wicked people your money, your hard-earned money. I can tell whether you're a sheep or a goat just by looking at your bank account. I can see where you spend your money. That's who you serve. If you continue to strengthen the hand of the ungodly, you just may find yourself in a real bad spot one day. When you face Jesus, when every knee bows and every tongue confesses, and you'll be in front of Jesus, and he will say, "Depart from me, you worker of iniquity." You have helped build sin upon sin. These companies support sinful things publicly, shamelessly. It's a shame that you take part in that support by giving them your money. Every time you give Starbucks your money, you are supporting sodomy. It won't last long, I can tell you that. No nation in history has ever lasted long once they start to go this route. Why? Because now you say men can marry men and they can adopt little children and put their abominable ways onto those little children. It won't last long. Why? Because God is a righteous God and he's going to judge you, America. God is righteous and holy. If he doesn't judge this nation for its wicked ways, he would have to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah. Woe unto you, America. You've been blessed by so much, and you use that blessing not to bless your fellow Christians, but to support these ungodly companies. Starbucks forcing Christians to bake gay wedding cakes. Target forcing you women to share your bathroom with men. You should think about this. Consider your ways. Consider your ways, America. It's time to repent. It's time to come out from among them. Touch not the unclean thing. These things are unclean. Everything they're selling you at Target, you could get it somewhere else. They don't have anything exclusive. All you're doing is supporting their ungodly agenda. That's all you're doing. And if you're in support of ungodliness, then you are in fact ungodly. I don't care about your baptism. I don't care about your rituals. I don't care about any of those things. Jesus said, "Why do you call me Lord and don't do the things that I do?" Repent. While there's still time, repent and be converted. If you're converted, you'd flee from sin. Even the appearance of evil would turn your stomach if you were saved. When you're saved, the Holy Spirit dwells inside of you. Can the Holy Spirit dwell with the harlot? No, God forbid. The Holy Spirit can't dwell in you unclean vessels, you goats that buy pews at the church to think that it makes your shame go away. So you made a lot of money and you support a high school. Wow, you did great things. I hear about Oprah. Oh, she gave this thousands and thousands of dollars. Well, she's got a billion, so what's it a problem to her? It's like me giving away a dollar. I don't cry about it in the street every time I do it. But she does. Whoopee. It's not going to do any good in eternity. All that money won't buy you one day in heaven. All that money won't do any good there. Naked you came into this world, and naked you will go right back out of it. When you're standing at the great white throne judgment, then Jesus is going to say, sheep, go to the right. Goats, go to the left. If you're a sheep, you suffer for God. You listen to Him. You depart from your sin. When something is shown to you to be sin, you don't hang on to it. You don't make excuses for it. But all you goats that say God knows your heart, and oh, well, God just loves me special. Well, I'm here to tell you, you're not special. You're no more special to God than every other soul on this planet. God is no respecter of persons. You think you're special because He got you out of trouble when you cried out. That time that you cried out, you said, God, if you get me out of this trouble, I'll change. And then the trouble passed and you went right back to your wicked ways. God wasn't giving you an okay. He was giving you time to turn from your wicked ways. God hates the workers of iniquity. God is angry with the wicked every day. None but the righteous are going to go to heaven. It's time to dust off your Bible, Christians. You think you can be saved just because you repeated John 3:16? If God wanted to save you with one verse, He would have gave you a fortune cookie. He didn't give you a fortune cookie. He gave you a library to know who He is. 40 prophets that died to give you a Bible, and you don't want to read it. You go on ignorant, and your ignorance will do you no good. When you stand before God, Romans 2 says you will be without excuse. Why? Because if you back it up to chapter 1, you'll see that because you know that the things you do are worthy of death, but not only do you continue in them, but you take pleasure in those that do them also. Though hand join in hand. You see, every abominable person in the world can line up in front of that target and tell me about how I'm the only one and I must be wrong. Well, I'm here to tell you I'm still in the majority if that happens, because God is bigger than every one of you, and He didn't mind to destroy the whole world save 8 people in the day of Noah. And I believe He'll do it again. He doesn't have any problem. He doesn't count numbers. He wants your heart. Your heart is either with Him or it's against Him. You're either serving God or you are serving the devil. Every soul out here is an eternal soul. Everyone here is going to live forever. You think I'm telling you good news, but that's not the good news. Most of you are going to live forever in hell. That's horrible news. Except you repent, you will likewise perish. It's time to get some understanding. Repent. Be saved. The time is running short. Every bit of air you breathe is one more than you were promised. You're going to face God one day. You better consider your ways. Jesus died that people could be reconciled back to the Father. He did not die for you to dive deeper into sin. You make his name a byword. Wicked generation. Dogs returning to their vomit. Jesus loved you enough to die on the cross that you might be saved. That part might that's in the verse, it hinges on you. What will you do with the salvation that you've been shown? Will you squander it away? Hide it away and go on in the world like you've always done? Or will you turn from your wicked ways? That's really the question. I'm not going to be the one judging you on Judgment Day. But I'm here to tell you who is. I'm here to tell you that the Holy Bible is going to be the standard of your judgment. Jesus said, "Why do you say you love me and do not the things that I do?" This is how we know that we love God, because we keep his commandments. They're not burdensome. They're not grievous. Even in this mixed up, twisted up world where they want to tell you that two men can be married, two women can be married. It's not hard to see who's right and who's wrong. Whose word is the final word? God. God's word is true. What does God's word say about it? God's word says that it's an abomination for two men to lie together like Do you think that God's going to change his mind because you committed to it? When you commit to sin, you are a sinner. Do you think that God is going to have mercy on you because you were just trying to be loving when you were supporting these wicked people? Maybe you're not doing that stuff yourself, but you keep shopping at Target, you're supporting them. You keep shopping at Starbucks, you're supporting them. Starbucks says they don't want Christians' business. I got to wonder why in the world anybody goes there. I don't think they'd make it if it was only the homosexuals that they're catering to buy their coffee. I don't think there's enough of them to keep them in business on every corner in America. No, I got to think if you Christians got some understanding and quit giving your money to the ungodly, I think their business would be short-lived. But the problem is, you that say you're a Christian, you're not really a Christian. You're just a goat. You're going to go to hell just like every other wicked person. Why? Because Jesus was in front of you and you did nothing. You did not respond. You denied his name. Jesus said, if you deny my name before the world, then I'll deny your name before the Father. You go on thinking you're saved when you deny his name. Every time you continue to strengthen ungodly businesses, every time you continue to go and give these companies your money, these companies that say publicly they don't care about Christians, don't want Christians' business. Starbucks says they don't want Christians' business. They only want homosexuals' business. Well, I think we should let the homosexuals keep them in business. You keep supporting an abomination, you're part of that abomination. This nation is going to be judged. This nation is going to be found lacking. The Bible says more than once, though hand join in hand, the wicked will not go unpunished. It's a wicked thing to know the Word of God and disregard it. It's a wicked thing even more. He said, if you add to this book, you'll find in your life all the plagues of this book. That's a wicked thing to try to add to God's Word by saying that, well, that was for a long time ago, and now it's okay because it's okay. We deemed it okay. Well, I don't care what you deemed okay. God called it an abomination. It's still an abomination. You need to get right with God. He's the only one that's going to let you into heaven, and He's the only one that can keep you out. Get some understanding. You that say you're a Christian and don't do the things that Jesus did. Cultural Christianity will not save you. Matter of fact, it will send you right to hell. You are a sheep. Unless you hear His voice, only if you hear His voice and you do that what He says. Otherwise, you're a goat. You can go to every service in town, have your name written on pews in every church across town. But when you stand before God, that's the day that's going to count. It won't be your money that He looks at. It won't be your church attendance that He looks at. It won't be any of the things that you think it will be, but it will be everything the Bible told you it would be. Read the Bible. God is going to judge you. And you that strengthen the hand of the ungodly, you're ungodly. Keep on shopping at Target. Keep on, let them go ahead and put those men in the women's bathroom. Keep on getting your Starbucks. Keep on forcing Christian businesses out of businesses for refusing to take part in abomination marriages. Keep on supporting that kind of stuff, and when you go before God, you're going to find out that He never knew you. Depart from me, worker of iniquity. God is angry with the wicked every day, but you could repent. You could repent. The problem is, light came into the world, and men chose darkness because their deeds were evil. Woe unto you, America! If the mighty works that have been done in America had been done in Sodom and Gomorrah, they would have long ago repented. Woe unto you that have heard the grace of God and tread it under your foot. May Jesus' name a byword. You got a cross on your dashboard and a filthy, wicked heart. You're going to go to hell. You're a goat. Most of you right now on this street claim to be Christians, and most of you are on the broad road, and most of you will go to hell. Straight is the way, narrow is the gate that leads to life. Few there be that find it. It's time. In all you're getting, get understanding. Repent and be converted. If you're supporting ungodly companies like Starbucks and Target that publicly shame Christians, telling you that they don't want your business, but you keep giving it to them, you should consider your ways. You're strengthened in the hand of the ungodly. That makes you, in fact, ungodly. Jesus said, why do you say you love me and don't keep my commandments? Why do you say you call me Lord and do not the things that I do? It's not love to support the ungodly. Love is to expose ungodliness. You like to quote 2 Corinthians 13. You say, oh, love is kind and love is gentle and love, love, love. But you forget the part that says, love rejoices not in iniquity. Love rejoices in the truth. You should read the whole chapter. You think you're performing love to go on supporting these wicked companies? You think that's love? You think it's love to support pedophiles in these bathrooms? Opening up the door for pedophiles in their bathroom? You think that's good? You think that's something God would have you to do? Do you really? Do you really think? And then you're going to blame God when bad things happen. When he left you here to do something about it, you refuse to fight. You refuse to stand up. You refuse to do anything about it. You let pedophiles in these restrooms, and you won't say anything about it because you're scared. You're scared of the world. That's why Target is allowing pedophiles in your restrooms right now, because you're scared of the world. You're scared of being called a bigot. You're scared of being called some kind of dinosaur. Well, I'm here to tell you, I will stand with God. If it's just me and God, I'm still in the majority against the rest of you. Light came into this world, and you got a choice to choose it or choose darkness. But that little water baptism that you did in the phony little ceremony doesn't do anything for your soul unless you accept that light into your life. If that light's in your life, you'll be bold. Daniel said in the last days, the people that believe in God would be bold and do exploits. This is that time, right now, when they want to let pedophiles into the bathroom, and we're not supposed to say anything about it. We're supposed to just sit back and allow it to happen. And then when those pedophiles start raping your children, then you're going to say, what kind of God would allow that to happen? He didn't allow it to happen. He sent you to do something about it. And you slept at the gate. You stayed asleep at the wheel. You stayed asleep at the wheel while they let those pedophiles in their bathroom to rape your children. And then you want to blame God about it. I'm here to tell you, it's not God's fault. It's your fault. Because you allow every wicked thing to go on. Because you're afraid that someone might call you a bigot. Go hand, join in hand. The wicked will not go unpunished. You let these pedophiles in this bathroom. You can't blame God. You did it to yourself. It's your fault, America. That's right. Faithful Christians that just said no, that just didn't want to be a part of somebody's abomination. If you go to a wedding, you're a witness before God that you're in agreement to that wedding. You won't drag me to no any kind of pervert wedding. Starbucks wants to force you to have to go there. Starbucks wants you to be forced to have to serve them. He said he doesn't want Christians' business, but you still keep giving it to them. It's time to get some understanding. You so-called Christians, you goats in sheep clothing. Jesus Christ is going to divide you up. He's going to put the sheep on this side and the goats on that side. You're going to go to the same hell that everybody else goes to. You understand there's only one hell? There's not one hell for wicked people, one hell for the goats. No. But you that play games with your Christianity, that spend your whole life supporting ungodliness, spend your whole life doing ungodly things, thinking that on the last day you're going to say, "Oh, Jesus, I'm so sorry." And on the last day you don't get out of all that. And the last day you're going to find out that you're lost. Some of you think you made a, you got baptized, you got dunked in some water. Well, I'm here to tell you, you can get dunked in every mud puddle in this county and the next one over. If the light is not in you, you're not saved. If the Holy Ghost doesn't dwell in you, you're not saved. If you don't understand what I'm saying, it's likely that it's true. If you don't know about being born again, it's likely that you are not born again. It doesn't matter what your grandma says. It doesn't matter what Uncle Dudley the deacon says. It doesn't matter about the money you spend in the church. God doesn't want your money. He wants your heart to be contrite and broken and recognize that you're a sinner and come before Him and ask Him for mercy. If you're truly broken, you won't be too quick to go back to that sin, but you'll turn from your sin. Godly sorrow worketh repentance. It's time to get understanding, America. Pedophiles are trying to get into the bathroom at Target, and you keep shopping there. Starbucks is trying to force businesses to serve and cater homosexual weddings, regardless of their faith. And you keep buying their coffee. There's half a dozen better coffee shops on this street. If I drank coffee, I'd get it somewhere else. That's for sure. It's a wicked thing to strengthen the hands of the ungodly. Jesus said, "Why do you say you love me and don't keep my commandments?" It's a wicked thing. Why is that? Because people blame God for the bad things that you could have done something about. That's right. When somebody gets raped in that bathroom because they want to stand up for some nut job that doesn't know what gender he is or she is. When somebody gets raped because you're not paying attention and you're not doing anything about the evil to come, you see it right in front of you, then when it happens, what's going to happen? Then they're going to say, "Oh, why would God allow it to happen? God didn't allow it to happen. He left you here to keep watch." God said in the Bible, watch and pray. You think you're a Christian and you keep supporting ungodly people, you're a goat. And you're going to go to the same hell everybody else goes to. That's right, goat. You're going to go to hell. I don't care about what grandma says. I don't care about what Uncle Dudley Do-Right the deacon says. They told you that if you go down in this water and then you come back up, it doesn't matter what you do. You're saved. Don't let anybody tell you different. They lied to you. They lied to you. It does matter what you do afterwards. The Bible says, should we continue in sin that grace would abound? God forbid. If you're living a God-forbidden life, you're a goat. And you're going to go to hell. You need to repent and get right with God. Last time I was here, someone told me that everybody that works at Starbucks is a Christian. I don't see how any real Christian wouldn't be looking for a new job. When these companies want to force ungodliness on us, they say that they don't want our business, but you want to keep giving it to them? You're messed up in your head. You don't have any light. If you had any light, you'd be running from these things. Flee from iniquity. Flee from the judgment that is to come. No good is going to come from this thing. You abominable people. Yes, abominable. If you would turn to God in truth and spirit, then you would overcome and you'd be blessed, because he said, blessed are they that overcome. That's right. If you overcome sin in this flesh, you're going to be blessed. Not if you make excuses for it, but if you overcome it. Blessed is he that overcomes. The 21st chapter of Revelation. For I shall be a father. I shall be your God. But the abominable murderers, you say you never killed anybody, but Jesus said, if you hate somebody without a cause in your heart, you commit murder in your heart. I could just go out on Highway 75 and see that most of you are murderers right now. The fearful, the unbelieving, abominable. Yes, that's what it is, abominable, to allow pedophiles into their bathroom at Target because they want to be politically correct, because it's not right to say men should go in the men's room and women should go in the women's room, because you've all drank this Kool-Aid and you won't stand up because you don't want to be called a bigot, because you don't want to suffer. But the Bible says, blessed is he that suffers. It's better to suffer as a Christian than as a murderer. When you don't stand up and you allow these pedophiles to go in their bathroom and rape our little children, you take part in that sin. You think that's okay? You think it's okay for pedophiles to rape our children? That's what Target thinks. They think it's okay. They think it's just no problem. We shouldn't be so bigoted. We shouldn't be so cautious. We're just fearful Christians. I'm here to tell you, we've been given a charge to keep. If you're a Christian, it's time to stand up and shine the light on this evil. You don't want to stand up because you're afraid. You're ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. It's the power of God that would set you free. If you wanted to be free, the problem is most people on this planet don't want to be free. Most people on this planet have heard the truth. Do you see, they've heard John 3:16 over and over and over and over again. And they hear it and they hear it and they hear it, but they don't receive it. Why? Because light came into the world and men chose darkness because their deeds are evil. If you don't stand up against this darkness, this pedophile supporting company Target, you shouldn't call yourself a Christian. You're ashamed to stand up for our children. There's something bad wrong. You say you love Jesus. He said, why do you say you love me? You call me Lord and don't do the things that I do. He stood up for truth. He stood up for justice. It's unjust to allow pedophiles into the restroom at Target and you don't do anything about it. You keep shopping there like nothing's going on. It is unjust. It's unholy. It's ungodly. And many of you say you're Christians and you keep on going on like nothing's happening. light came into the world, and men chose darkness because their deeds were evil. You think you're not evil because you're not like something you saw in a Hollywood movie? You think evil's got horns and a pitchfork and a tail? You think evil is a bank robber, a serial killer? But let me tell you what evil really is. Evil is somebody that tells themselves they're good and lets evil things flourish in their life without standing up because they don't want to say anything. They don't want to be mean, or I can't judge them. You need to judge. I'm here to tell you, Christians, the Bible says, know ye not that you will judge the angels. It's time to get some discernment. It's time to get some understanding. You talk about love, I tell you about love. 2 Corinthians 13:6 says, love rejoices not in iniquity. You see, the love of Jesus doesn't rejoice in this filthiness that is Target, pedophile supporting company, Starbucks, homosexual abomination supporting company. No, love rejoices not in iniquity, but love rejoices in the truth. It's time to hear the truth. You've heard it over and over and over and over. For God so loved the world. Yes, he did. Sadly, you don't recognize that that is past tense. He loved the world when he went on the cross and died to reconcile you from your sin. When you reject that gift, you become a worker of iniquity. And Psalms 5:5 says that God hates the worker of iniquity. You think you can just be saved by John 3:16? If God could save you with just one verse, he would have gave you a fortune cookie. He didn't give you a fortune cookie, he gave you a Bible. You should read it. Put down your horoscope. Pick up your Bible. Get some understanding. Come out from among them. Touch not the unclean thing. How long are you going to keep on supporting ungodly organizations and talk about Jesus? If you love Jesus, you keep his commandments. He commands you to abstain from even appearance of evil. Ephesians says you should abstain from the appearance of evil. You need to repent, America. God is going to judge you. God hates the workers of iniquity. That's what these companies represent. Starbucks, they stand up to force Christians to make gay wedding cakes. Target is forcing men into women's bathrooms, and you're not doing anything about it. You keep shopping there. You're part of their wickedness. You're just as wicked as they are. It's time to repent. When Jonah went to Nineveh, that great city, when the king heard the truth, he turned and he caused that even the cattle were fasting. Because they recognized what it meant to be in the hands of a true and living God. You don't realize that, or you would repent likewise. You think it's just lovey-dovey Jesus with his thumbs up, and he's just patting you on the back while you go on in your sin. You have a false idol. That's not Jesus. My Jesus, the real Jesus, the one that came like a lamb on behalf of your sin the first time. When he comes back, he's coming back like a lion, and he's going to set some things straight. He doesn't love your sin. He hates it. He's filled to the brim with your wicked ways. And because you've made an idol out of his image, you are an idolater, and you will be judged on the great white throne judgment. You will be judged as an idolater, and you will go to a real hell. None but the righteous shall see God. Keep on serving Facebook Jesus, and you're going to go to hell. You better repent. You have made yourself your own God, a God that serves you. This is a lie from the beginning. You were made to serve him, not the other way around. God does not come to serve you, but you were made to serve him. The word worship in the Hebrew is synonymous with the word slave or servant. If you're serving God, you're not serving this world. You can't serve two masters. Either you love this one and hate the other, you cling to this one and let go of the other, but you're going to serve, you can only serve one. You better make your decision. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Come to him. Depart from all this worldliness, Target that wants to put men in your women's bathrooms, and Starbucks that wants to force you to take part in all their abomination wedding services. They say they don't want Christians' business. If I drank coffee, I sure wouldn't get it there. It's time to consider your ways. You're strengthened in the hand of the ungodly. When you go to Target, down the road, when somebody gets raped in their bathroom because they let pedophiles in their bathroom, then somebody's going to cry out and say, why would God let this happen? And the truth of the matter is, God didn't want it to happen. He sent people like myself to warn you of what was going to happen, and you ridicule us and you stone us just like the prophets have ever came into this world. What prophet has come before you that you have not stoned? And then when they're dead, your sons and daughters make temples and you make monuments to them. You make monuments because you know not the truth. You don't want the truth. Light came into the world and men chose darkness because their deeds were evil. You don't come to the light because you know you're evil. And if you come to the light, you'll be reproved. You don't want to be told about your sinful ways. But he that loves the truth comes to the light, that his life might be manifest that it is wrought of God. It's time to get some understanding. Read the whole book. You read John 3:16 like it's the only verse in the whole Bible. That's why you don't understand. The very next verse says, God did not send his son to condemn the world, but that through him the world might be saved. Key word in that verse is might. Might. You think God won't destroy this land and keep only a remnant? You're wrong. In the days of Noah, Noah preached righteousness while he built that ark for 100 years. He preached righteousness and nobody took heed. And on the day that the flood came, God destroyed the whole world minus 8 people. For God did not send his son to condemn the world, but that through him the world might be saved. Might. That's up to you. Do you receive him and come to the light? Do you come to the truth? Do you feel shame when you sin? Do you ask forgiveness and go away from it? Or do you just walk further into it and your heart gets harder and harder? Most of you are like the Pharaoh in Egypt. Every time he was in trouble, he cried out to God. And every time the trouble passed, he went right back and got worse and worse. Most of you are going to go to hell. Most of you think that you're special because Grandma told you you could do anything you wanted to do. And Grandma told you that just call out on Jesus when you're in trouble and he'll get you out. She failed to tell you that the wages of sin is death. She failed to tell you that God is no respecter of persons. What he does to one, he'll do to all. That what he did to Sodom and Gomorrah, he'll do to this wicked generation too. That's right. God is no respecter of persons, only the righteous. How do you be righteous? That's a good question. If you want to be righteous, turn to Jesus. The blood of Jesus is the only thing that can wash you and make you righteous before God. But I'm here to tell you that many of you have went down another way. You think you know Jesus. You think he's there to forgive you for all your sins, that you can keep on sinning. But the Bible says, should I continue in sin, that grace would abound? God forbid. If you're living a life that God forbids, you need to find the real Jesus. Most of you will go to hell. I can say this with all confidence because the Bible says it's true. The Bible says many are on the road that leads to destruction. But straight is the way, narrow is the gate that leads to life, and few there be that find it. There's a way to know if you love Jesus. The Bible says that them that are deceived with all deceivableness, because they love not the truth. When you hear the truth, do you rail against it? When someone tells you about the fornication you're living in, do you come up with all kind of excuses? Do you laugh and joke and make jokes about ungodliness? Oh yes, God is watching. The time is short. You better repent. God is going to judge you. God is going to come back with a sword. And he's going to take his flaming sword and he's going to wipe out every worker of iniquity. It's time to get understanding. The time is short. Woe unto you, America. Woe unto you, Cartersville. You say you're saved and you go on in sin, you're lost. You say you love God, but you can't stop sinning. You don't love God. You hate God. You hate his very mention. Every time he's mentioned, you cringe. Why? Because you know that you love your sin more than him. When you continue in sin, it's because you love sin more than you love God. This is whereby we know that we love God when we keep his commandments. They're not grievous. They're not burdensome. It's not hard to keep myself. And if I sin, I have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ. who's able to wash me from all uncleanness. It's like he washed me, and it's like it never happened. But you that have turned the grace of God into license, your spots and blemishes on the feast of charity, your goats before God, Jesus is going to take the sheep and put them on the right, and the goats are going to go on the left. All of you that have a form of godliness but refuse to stand up for righteousness, refuse to stand up against yourself when you're tempted, refuse to find the way of escape that God has promised, you're a goat and you're going to find yourself in hell. It's better that you had not known. You that have tasted the things of God and went backwards like a dog returning to its vomit. Repent.